do not know yet. We're outside Lantigua headquarters. His supporters just arriving, as you say. He's supposed to make a statement shortly. We spent much of our day looking through the window, watching people review election paperwork. The challenger, as you say, won by a whisker, and today he was thankful for every vote.
Gracias a la gente de Lawrence. Thank you to the brave folks who put their city first.
Daniel Rivera celebrated a little, but with only 60 votes separating his total from current Mayor William Lantigua, Rivera also called on Lantigua to move on.
The votes show there was a majority of people that voted for me. We are clearly divided as a community. I think that has to stop.
In a basement room of City Hall, attorneys for each campaign and the city oversaw the ballot process today. City police, at the direction of the Secretary of State, guarded the ballots overnight.
There's been a long history of controversy regarding Lawrence politics, and we felt the way to prevent any rumors or any questions was to put a police officer in place. Now,
Mayor Lantigua's parking space remained empty. He wasn't in. So far, he has not said whether he'll demand a recount. Lantigua has faced past charges of campaign finance violations and two recall attempts.
The city is clearly divided. You know, if the mayor decides that he wants, that it benefits him to have a recount, we'll do it, we'll defend ourselves. But I think this is a time to heal, and we'll take this moment now for that. But if it comes to come, we fought for every vote, we'll defend every vote, and we'll make sure that this election does not get stolen.
And a recount is not automatic. Someone has to call for it. Clearly, the Rivera forces are satisfied, so we will have to wait just a little bit to find out what William Lantigua will do, if he wants a recount or not. Reporting live from Lawrence, I'm Pam Frost, WCVB News Center 5.